We all know the importance of staying hydrated. Well, being hydrated is equally important to our cats. The lack of it causes various symptoms, which can lead to huge problems, even death. In the long term, mild dehydration is also problematic, as it can lead to several issues, which in turn can shorten your cat's lifespan. So it's crucial to make sure Kitty drinks enough water. In this video, I'll discuss the most common mistakes cat owners make that can lead to dehydration in cats. I'll also tell you how to figure out if your cat drinks enough water. Let's start. One of the biggest mistakes you can make is to place the water bowl close to the food dish. Yep, that's right. Forget about those double bowls. Even if they're cute and convenient, they're not great for Kitty. The reason is pretty straightforward. If we look at how cats naturally behave, cats don't like to drink water from the same spot they're eating, which totally makes sense. Cats are vulnerable when drinking water, so they prefer a safe space where predators aren't drawn to their prey's smell. In the case of household cats, the prey equals their food dish. And while no dangers lurk around, their instinct remains. Another mistake is to place the water bowl near the litter box. Obviously, a dirty bowl filled with dust or hair will not entice Kitty either, so make sure to keep it clean. But there's also a more subtle cause that can easily be overlooked: the material of the bowl. Plastic is more porous than stainless steel, so it can capture odors and bacteria. In time, this can lead to a funky water smell, which cats can certainly detect, even if we can't. Additionally, the water you're giving your cat might not be top quality. Cats enjoy fresh water, so Kitty might be reluctant to drink tap water that smells of chemicals. I strongly suggest ensuring your cat has good quality water at all times. But your cat might not be into drinking water, even if you don't make any of the mistakes I mentioned. While unfortunate, this behavior also makes sense. Cats following a natural diet get almost all of their water requirements from eating, so drinking a lot of water can simply feel unnatural to cats. Luckily, some easy solutions can fix this issue. You can start by changing the water several times a day. If that doesn't cut it, go for a water fountain. Cats love drinking from running water instinctively, as it's usually fresher than a stagnant one. A water fountain is a great way to entice Kitty, and there are many options available. I also got one for my cats, and they love it. I especially recommend it for cats who are intrigued by faucets. But let's say you try this and it doesn't work. There are two more tricks you can try. Firstly, you can flavor the water with some tuna water or chicken broth. Unsalted, of course. Many cats, if not all, will not be able to resist it. Secondly, Kitty might not drink water because she's not fond of its location. In this case, get several water recipients and place them in different locations. And if you have multiple cats, this is a must. So what can you do if none of these work? Well, I would strongly suggest getting your cat checked out by a vet to rule out any health issues. But if Kitty is healthy, then I would suggest feeding her only wet food. In this case, she'll be able to get most of her water intake from it. Just make sure to be extra vigilant with your cat's teeth. When I fed my cats wet food exclusively, they developed severe tartar issues. This is, however, my experience, and I'm not a vet, so make sure to discuss this subject with one. But what are your cat's liquid requirements after all? Typically, a cat should drink from 3.5 to 4.5 ounces of water per 5 pounds of body weight every day. The water intake can vary depending on temperature, humidity, and activity level. You have to be more careful if your cat is eating only dry food. If we consider the average, a 9-pound cat will need approximately 6.76 ounces. Let's see a comparison between dry and wet food. A 9-pound indoor cat eating canned food will have to drink a small amount of water. On the other hand, dry food contains almost no moisture, so the same cat eating kibbles will have to get nearly all of its water intake separately. How can you tell if your cat drinks enough water? First of all, you can check for dehydration signs by testing the elasticity of your cat's skin. To do that, gently pinch your cat's back skin, as I did here, and release it. If your cat is properly hydrated, her skin will return almost instantly. If your cat has mild dehydration, it will take a bit of time for the skin to return. In more serious cases, the skin will come back with difficulty, or not at all. Also, the cat will be lethargic, will have an elevated heart rate, and sunken eyes. Go to the vet immediately if you suspect this is the case, or notice any sudden behavior involving your cat's drinking habits. You can also test your cat's gums by gently pressing on them. In healthy cats, the gum's color should change back to pink instantly. Here's a list of health issues that can cause dehydration. If Kitty has them, she can actually drink too much water and still be dehydrated. Measuring how much water your cat is drinking is a great way to know if your cat is healthy. Even if it might seem hard, It isn't. The first step is relatively easy, figuring out how much water evaporates. For this, pour water as you would typically do. Measure it and leave it be for 24 hours. And figure out a way to keep your cat away. After a day, measure it again to see how much water evaporated. And now, pour the same amount of water again and leave it for another 24 hours. This time, allow your cat to drink from it. It's time to measure it again. Subtract the evaporated water and voila! This is how much water your cat drinks in a day. If you do this test, make sure to repeat it if there are multiple seasons where you live. Keep in mind, some variations can occur when measuring. And now, I'd really think you'd love this video, in which I talk about another common mistake cat owners make. See you there!